Hawskbee and Jacobs here on Talk Sport. You probably will be familiar with the prank phone calls of Bart Simpson to Mo of Moe's Tavern in The Simpsons. If not, this is a prime example.
Hey, just a sec, I'll check. Amanda Hug and Kiss? Hey, I'm looking for Amanda Hug and Kiss. Why can't I find Amanda Hug and Kiss?
Maybe your standards are too high.
There we are. Get the idea with that. And it's but it's happened in the world of football now to AFC Fylde substitute stadium announcer, Liam Brown. Good afternoon, Liam.
How you doing, guys? You okay?
Yes, not too bad. Look, you know, it can happen to the best of us. Don't beat yourself up. We'll handle it as delicately as we can. We'll point at basically some young kids said their dad was blocked in his white Nissan Micra. N14ABJ. Now, that, I think we get the idea, of course, and I think most people would have gone with that. Why would they? Young kids can't get home because their dad's blocked in, and we don't blame you.
What I want to know, though, from Liam, is when did you realise? Was it the minute it came out of your mouth, or did people start laughing? When did you realise that they'd had you?
The little urchin that came over and handed me the piece of paper was so, he was so earnest that he looked at me and just said, oh, my dad's blocked in, can you please just read this out? I had a quick look over it, didn't see anything untoward. I mean, the worst bit about it after I read it out was, it was about 5 minutes before I realised when the groundsman came over and said, mate, you're an idiot. He's got you, well and truly got you there. Yeah. I was like, oh my God.
And now the good thing, though, is the club, rather than ban them for life, having in a sense of humour failure,
rewarded them.
They've got a bit of a reward for it, haven't they?
Yeah, I'm not sure I agree with it. I, you know, I'd probably bring back corporal punishment in school or national service or something like this. But the club have been pretty good with it. They've invited them in and given them free shirts and AFC file gear and things like that. I think the club are in a good mood because they just reached the first ever FA Trophy quarter final and the fourth in the league playing good football. So a bit happy times around there. So they reacted well to it.
And also, the lads are season ticket holders at the club, and you need to nurture that, don't you, as a club? So. It's good that they've seen had a bit of a sense of humour.
It is concerning to what kind of people they're turning to when they're a little bit older, but I thought it was very, very funny.
I mean, ultimately, it's a bit of old-school double entendre. There'll be a lot of people out there listening saying, I don't get it. Well, fine, you don't get it. So, but they're the people that do. You know, if they've got it, then it's not going to offend them, is it, you wouldn't think?
No, of course not, no. I'm going to make sure I never get done with it again. I've been spending the last 2 days learning the NATO phonetic alphabet. If there's any more announcements like that, it'll be November Echo 1-4 Alpha Beta Juliet.
Oh, well done. So, I
wonder how the club tracked them down, because you imagine...
Oh, there's a picture of them, isn't there? The kind of thumbs up they're giving, so they were quite easy to find.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, I took that photograph. They came over to Gloss at the end of the game.
Oh, no.
There was nothing, at that point, there was nothing for it other than to shake the hands and say, fair play, you got me. They actually did get a video of it. If you go to the AFC Fylde Twitter, one of the lads actually replied with a video of me reading it out, so you can all have a good laugh at that as well.
Oh, no.
I take it someone somewhere has got that number plate, haven't they? Not necessarily on a Nissan Micra.
I have no idea. Yeah. I'd be very interested to find out.
Yeah,
it must be worth quite a bit of money.
It probably would be. Now, we have the clips of the week every Friday on the show, and I'm given a list of names to read out.
And people don't always
put the right names in, and I'm sometimes slightly worried that it could be a career ender. So you do have to be careful.
I'm sure Chris Moore's got me as well.
Oh, he got you with a few corkers over the years, yeah. So you were the substitute, you were the stand-in. So what was the circumstances that found you doing this then?
Yeah, well, I was standing for Brian, who's the normal announcer. I actually work for a championship club, who I'm not going to name because I don't want them associated with my failures. But I was just filling in for Brian. So the only saving grace in this is that Brian's going to get all the blame. So everybody's going to think he did it when he comes back on Saturday for the Chesterfield game.
I worked at Chelsea at one time, and Carl, who did the PA announcements there, when I'm going up to the control room where he would do his thing, announce the substitutes and stuff, and invariably 6-8 to go into labour one day, and it's not going to get read out because no one will believe it.
That's true. The normal club I work at, we have minions to protect me from the cruelty of the outside world, but they tend to say just tell them to ring home and things like that, rather than saying that your missus has gone into labour.
Yeah. I wonder why that's still a staple. They're probably still trying it to this day. It's good you're telling us they are.
Yeah, so that's interesting.
Fantastic. Well, look, good to talk to you. And say, look, don't beat yourself up. I think we've all been there. And it's good that the club have had a bit of a sense of humour about it. So thanks very much.
Yeah. Definitely, it was very funny.
There we are. Liam Brown there, AFC Fylde announcer, sitting in for the regular man and got done.
He certainly did.
Yeah. It's Hawksbee and Jacobs.